Most people in life are looking for how do I make a life worth living or retirement with having. We do that by participating in our own lifeline. Our own lifeline is what we create after we leave our mother and father's house, according to the Bible and Quran. And when we do that, we have the right to produce the loving relationships we need for our life. Some people play into our life and then they play out quickly after they've used us and abused us. But liars about love are the ones we have to be careful of. Because a liar about love will play just long enough to catch your attention, and then they'll walk away as if they did nothing wrong. I didn't do anything but offer you friendship. Bullshit. You offered a hell of a lot more than that. And when we start to tell the story of a love life gone wrong, we have to see who the abusers are, the profilers are, and how men stalk women and pretend to be like them. Now, what do we mean by that? I mean that a profiler will study a woman a long time, and then he'll put himself in a grocery store, and he'll then find a way to approach her, and then all of a sudden he's married to her with more. But then in the middle of that relationship, he doesn't start to feel his manhood anymore because she's a real looker and she can talk to anyone, and he feels less than he should. He feels less than he is. And she hasn't figured out in her maturity how to help him feel okay. But she's also one of those girls who wants a fixer-upper so that she can say, I fixed him, I repaired him, because of me, he is this. That is a little bit of mental illness. But when you learn that lesson, when he walks away after he's fucked all your friends and you didn't know it, even the fat ones he's done because they want him and they want that power to say to you sometime, you know, I fucked him, didn't you? And then I might be married to a marvelous pastor. But when a real friend tries to produce a birthday and say, I'd really like to do this for her because of all she does for us and how she shows up all the time for us, despite the fact that we're failing. We're not able to move this particular sideline project. That bitch of that pastor, that wife, allegedly a Christian, goes at it with such immorality, it's not even funny. She alludes that the man's trying to do something illegal or immoral behind her back, and all I was going to do with my family, who's great at creating welcoming and hospitality parties, was create a birthday party for someone I loved.